ang official version ng QCPD, General Tore. Bakit nagkaganon? Wait.
Saling aspeto ng investigation, sir? May I clarify, Your Honor?
Yeah, bakit hanggang alarm or scandal lang ang napail yung kaso? Nakita man sa video na mayroong baril na binunot at kinasa. Hanggang alarm or scandal lang bang kaya nating ipapataw doon?
Your Honor, the video, the viral video came into my attention at around noontime. I was having lunch in my office. It's a Sunday. And it was passed to me, and I made a comment, actually, on hindsight, I'm a little bit, it's a very strongly worded comment. I said there, if I can recall it, not on exact words, but the first word, the first line there is, yari kang kalbo ka. Pinakagagawin ang pinakadapat mong gawin ay sumurrender sa pinakamalapit na police station para hindi na
pati
tayo.
Ako tinamaan ako doon sa
sorry for that, Your Honor.
Sinasabi mo eh.
Sorry for that.
Anyway, pareho kaming kalbo na retired na police, ha? Pareho kami. Sige, go ahead. Continue.
I apologize, Your Honor. Yari ka, that's what I said, and then I said, you better go to the, mas mabuti pang pumunta ka rin sa pinakamalapit na police station at sumurrender dahil makikilala ka rin namin at hindi na tayo mapagod pa because at that time, nakapublish na rin ang kanyang plate number. So, I asked my investigation personnel to actually look into the matter and look for him. And, in 30 minutes, the media is all over me already. The media, because it is a Sunday and it's a slow day, are coming over to ask for my comment after I posted that comment. So I have good relations with the media. I ask them, come over if you have nothing to do. Let's have some coffee in my office. Fortunately or unfortunately for me, they came over at around 2 o'clock. 3:15, Mr. Gonzalez came over my office. I was already given the feedback that he was already located. It's very, very easy for my personnel to look for him because some of my personnel knew him. So I told them, bring that guy over here and let's talk. And when he came over the office, I got some initial interrogation. And that's the first thing that he told me, that it is already settled. He had already made peace with the other party. And in my assessment, indeed, I think it was an issue. I thought it was an issue already. Considering that it happened on August 8, it was already August 27 or 28, and it's already around 3 weeks. So I assessed that if there's somebody who is really aggrieved in this matter, they would have already come out in the open and have already made a ruckus in the media or in the other forum. Now that, with that assessment, the media had been pestering me and badgering me for my comment and requesting for Mr. Gonzalez to be interviewed. I am now in quandary whether to grant their request or not. And on hindsight, again, giving us a 2020 vision, I should have done it in a different manner. What I should have done is I have made a statement to the media and let Mr. Gonzalez go his own merry way and face the media on his own. However, I made that wrong move of bringing him in front of the media when I made a statement. He's just in another room and I asked him to be brought to me. And for that, I drew the flak and as a contrition and as an admission of the guilt of that oversight, I resigned my position as Quezon City Director, sir.
And I commend you for that.
Thank you, sir.
Please, hindi ka kapito ko sa position mo. At hindi mo binigyan ng mabigat na problema yung CPNP na hanggang aabot kay CPNP yung pambabas sa social media. Tama, yes, yung ginawa mo. Umalis ka kaagad.
Even at that time, sir, if I may continue, Your Honor.
Yeah, go ahead.
Even if during the time, I have already gathered all the evidences. After 24 hours, I gathered the evidences to support whether the matter is indeed closed and dropped and closed. I have asked the station commander to give me the CCTV coverage of the investigation room when the person arrived, because there were allegations that the cyclist was allegedly harassed, was kinaladkad, etc., etc. So I asked the station commander to actually give me the CCTV footages, because Station 11 is a smart police station. The CCTV there had microphone pickups. We hear every sound that made around the CCTVs. And also at that time,
as we speak, I think hindi mo kailangan yun. Galing naman mismo sa kanya. Yes, tinanong natin dito.
Yes, sir.
Open na dito sa open na hearing nito na hindi man doon siya hinaras, hindi siya tinakot, and he was satisfied with what you did, but that's according to him. Yes, siya naman ang complainant, di ba?
Thank you, sir, for that affirmation. However, even with until this point, I believe that the only oversight I did was allow him to be interviewed beside me, but he will be interviewed nonetheless in other forum, in other venues. And however, because of that, I still tendered my resignation, considering that I just want to protect my unit, Quezon City Police District, and the PNP in general, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, go ahead.
Anyway, gaya din na sinabi ni Chairman De La Rosa, we commend you, no, for owning up to your lapse.
Thanks, sir.
Nag-resign kayo voluntarily, Gerald Torre. However, parang merong incidents kayo ni gusto lang i-clarify with Mayor Belmonte, of course, who is your Chief Executive Officer of your city. Ano po ang nangyari sa inyo? Parang hindi kayo nagkaroon ng pagkakaunawan regarding this issue.
I do understand, sir, that when I had a long talk with the mayor before I tendered, after I tendered my resignation, she accommodated me. I asked for an audience to just personally apologize to her.
Pero nagalit po kasi siya.
Yes, sir.
Sa nangyari.
Yeah.
That's why. Okay.
Yes, yes, sir, Honor. The bottom line there is that she pointed out that I could have handled it in a better way. And she really pointed out that she just did not like the idea that was projected by that press conference with the main actor, main perpetrator, and until now the main suspect, that if you may, sitting beside me for that during that press con. And
did you acknowledge that it was a lapse on your part?
I did, sir. That's why I tendered my resignation.
Yeah. Tama rin po kasi if you're Mayor Joy Belmonte, parang lumalabas in perception wise na parang pinaboran nyo kasi si Mr. Gonzalez.
Yes, sir.
By doing that.
I do.
So we commend you for manning up. Marami kasi naghahanap ng nagtuturo eh. At least kayo, sinabi the buck stops here, kayo ang umamin na nagkamali po kayo.
Yes, sir. And I do believe that everything that my personal did was within the rules, except for some lapses, minor lapses. However, with in light of that CCTV going viral, I asked my station commander, Station 11, to file the case of alarm and scandal, because it is one case that we need no private complainants. So it was done on 1 hour after the opening of the offices on Tuesday. The viral video went out on Sunday. Monday was a holiday. Tuesday was the first working day of the week. And at 10:05, the case was already filed in court.
Just for the record, talaga bang pinaboran mo si Mr. Willie Gonzalez dahil dati siyang police, kaya inaccommodate mo doon sa opisina mo at pinapapriscom mo pa, kasama ka? Was that really your intention na bigyan siya ng pabor?
No, sir, because I really don't have any reason to do so, because I don't know him, and that's the first time I met him, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair?
Yes?
Before we continue, siguro pwede lang, with your indulgence, can we ask Attorney Raymond Fortune?
Yes, actually.
Kasi siya naman yung unang nag-post talaga nito regarding yung video kayo po yung nag-post as a lawyer and as a cycling enthusiast. Probably you can you probably can say something to this committee.
Yeah, actually I was about to call him after Gerald Torres. Please go ahead, Attorney Porton. This time you are our resource person. You're not counsel. Yeah, you are a resource person. So you have all the time in the world to express what you want to express.
Chairman, Mr. Senator Bato de la Rosa, Senator JV Ejercito, the other honorable members of the Senate Committee on Public Order, magandang tanghali po sa inyo. At around 10:30 a.m. of August 27, 2023, a member of Pinoy Road Bikers Incorporated, a SEC-registered cycling forum, of which I am one of the moderators. And after expressing to me his concern about how a friend of his was maltreated by a gun-toting motorist, forwarded to me a video of a road rage incident that occurred 2 weeks prior. I could have easily ignored it. Hindi naman yung siklista ang naagrabyado ang lumapit sa akin for my help. Nakakatakot yung itsura nung naglabas at kumasa ng baril. And my initial instincts was not to get involved. However, a voice inside me, a conscience that has been molded by my favorite saint, Saint Jose Maria Escriva, whispered to me that this man had done the same act of threatening others in the past. This wasn't the first and last time he will do it to a cyclist, a motorcyclist, another motorist, or a neighbor. Saint Jose Maria has exhorted laymen to be spontaneous in moments like these, to be selfless despite the obvious risks to life, to be a saint in the middle of the world. I posted a video on my Facebook page and asked for help to identify the gun-toting individual. I knew that there was no financial gain for this act. I have no political agenda, as I'm not even a member of any political party or organization. Hindi ko kailangan magpasikat. My close friends and even the media know that I enjoy my privacy. But my duty as the moderator of the largest cycling forum in the Philippines and my duty as a citizen of this country compelled me to help the poor cyclist, to get this madman off the streets, to protect other Filipinos who might be his victims in the future. Nung kinagabihan, nag-usap kami mismo nung siklista. Sinabi niya na takot siya para sa pamilya niya. Kahit na nangako ako na ilapit siya sa mga senador tulad ni Senator J.D. Ejercito, Bato de la Rosa, or Pia Cayetano. Kahit na sinabi ko na ibibigay ko sa kanya ang lahat ng attorney's fees ko kung ito ay ibibigay ng husgado. Tinanggihan niya ang aking alok na tulong legal dahil sa tinding takot para sa kapakanan ng kanyang pamilya. Ginamit niya po yung word na riding in tandem. Pwede niya pong aminin yan ngayon. His refusal to avail of free legal services did not dishearten me. Instead, it steeled my determination to pursue this matter even if it meant exposing my family to danger. For I come from a state university where the graduates live by the motto, kung hindi tayo kikibo, sinong kikibo? Kung hindi tayo kikilos, sinong kikilos? Honorable senators, I come to this hallowed chamber to ask for your help. Yes, you do have the power to conduct investigations to ferret out the truth not only on what happened between Alan Bandiola and Wilfredo Gonzalez on August 8, 2023, but also to find out from where Mr. Gonzalez acquired the temerity to pull out and cock his gun on an unarmed cyclist. Sinong nagbigay sa kanya ng lakas ng loob? Sino ang kanyang sinasandalan? Ano ang ginawa ng mga responding policemen? Why was Bandiola left alone, afraid and hungry for 5 hours at Galas Police Station? The only outcome being a handwritten kasunduan that even left out the details of the grave threats committed by this ex-policeman, who should be held responsible for Bandiola's seeming loss of faith, that his honor would be vindicated and that the perpetrator would be punished. As a Filipino citizen, I ask the honorable senators to see if our laws need to be amended to ensure that only those who are psychologically fit would be given guns, to increase the penalties for gun holders who are found to have misused the guns they have been privileged to possess, to provide for funds to increase the number of closed-circuit televisions in all barangays for the protection of all, and to instill upon the Philippine National Police to live by its promise, quote, to serve and to protect, close quote. Finally, I believe it is about time that a law be passed that truly encompasses the needs and protection of cyclists, to consider tax incentives to companies that provide bike parking areas and shower facilities, to consider giving tax exemptions to employees who use their bicycles instead of their cars as a practical way of decongesting Metro Manila streets, to reduce the customs duties and taxes for bike parts so that the same may become more reasonable for the bike to work community, and to improve the bike lane infrastructure so that more people will be encouraged to use the bike lanes in going to and coming from work, if not for exercise. What happens to Mr. Gonzalez is not my concern. That is a police matter. Kung ayaw ng siklista na makulong si Mr. Gonzalez para di na mangyari sa iba yung ginawa sa kanya, nasa sa kanya na yon. My only wish is that out of the Senate investigation, laws will be passed for the protection and good of all, for cyclists as well as the general public. I have faith that you fine gentlemen and ladies of the Senate can make this happen during our time. Maraming po salamat.